Fellow Nigerians, it is no longer news that the Nigerian government is currently taking actions to curtail the use of the social media in this 21st century. Not long ago, the Nigerian Minister of Information, Lai Mohammed, hinted that it was become necessary to enact a law that will regulate free speech on the internet. So they needed somebody in the Senate to initiate the move, and Senator Mohammed Musa of Niger State presented himself, and he came up with a bill titled Protection from Internet Falsehood and Manipulation Bill 2019. They want to tell us what to say so that they can tell us how to think. Very soon, the government of Nigeria will teach us how to breathe with our nostrils. But I am here to tell you that that bill is not an original document. It was plagiarized from another country. The title of the bill, where it was copied from, is Protection from Online Falsehood and Manipulation Act 2019 of the Republic of Singapore. My research shows that the act was passed by the Singaporean Parliament on the 8th of May 2019 and assented to by their president, Halimah Yacob, on the 3rd of June 2019. Our senators are copycats. I am standing here as Frederick Omoyemo Odorega, Global Coordinator of the Global Coalition for Security and Democracy in Nigeria, to challenge Senator Musa Mohammed of Niger State for plagiarism. You plagiarized the law of another country and want Nigeria to copy from it. Apart from plagiarizing the title, you also plagiarize part of the contents, and it is shameful. So what did he do? What did he do? He exchanged the word online for internet, but the other sentence is exactly the same, even in content. You see, that was how Muhammadu Buhari also plagiarized a speech by former president of the United States, Barack Obama. Buhari had to apologize publicly, and that is a national embarrassment. So you can see that there is no originality in government. That was not only the instance that the federal government has plagiarized other documents. In this modern age, in this cyber world. And you see, that is why you see that most of the Nigerian senators or legislators are always sleeping on duty. They should first consider life imprisonment for legislators who sleep during sessions. You cannot be waking up from your slumber regularly and you jump up to say yay, nay. At the end of the month, you receive tens of millions in Naira. That is national sabotage. We already have the Cybercrime Prohibition Prevention Act or law, which was passed during the administration of former President Jonathan Goodluck in May 2015. You know, dictatorship is usually a slow but steady process that comes into force because of the long silence of the people. But even NAFDAC knows that every dictator has an expiry date. Now, they want to cage our freedom of expression and human rights, just as they always try to suppress our freedom of association through intimidation, tear gassing, and shooting to kill whenever Nigerians protest injustice. As if that is not enough, the Senate is working on another law against hate speech and a commission to be known as the National Commission for the Prohibition of Hate Speeches. Come on! That insidious bill was sponsored by the Deputy Chief of the Senate, Abdullahi Aliyu Sabi. He should have just turned his name to not just Sabi, Ovasabi. Alaji Ovasabi. Also from the same Niger State. They proposed life imprisonment or death sentence for offenders as part of their next level agenda. If all Nigerian youths cooperate, they will understand that it is even a hate speech. It is even hate speech. When Buhari referred to them as lazy. We already have laws that criminalizes certain expressions For example, section 373, 375, and 376 of the Nigerian Criminal Code Act, as well as the Defamatory and Offensive Publication Act, criminalizes defamation. Again, section 418 of the Penal Code, which says that whoever circulates, publishes, or produces any statement, rumor, or report which he knows or has reason to believe to be false, with intent to cause, or which is likely to cause fear or alarm to the public, whereby any person may be induced to commit an offense against the public peace, shall be punished with imprisonment, which may extend to 3 years, or with fine, or with both. We also have section 59, subsection 1 and 2 of the Criminal Code Act, and section 418 of the Penal Code Act. These are used to try false publication of offenses. So why do you need more of such laws? These people, they do not understand the real problems we have in Nigeria. There is something very interesting about the so-called falsehood and manipulation law. And that is what I'm going to discuss now. So underline the word internet falsehood and manipulation. Underline that word. If there is a government that has used the internet and other social media to boldly propagate falsehood and manipulation, it is this government of Muhammadu Buhari. Was it not this government that propagated falsehood that it cost 3.5 million naira to feed El Zakzaki in prison monthly? Was it not this government that propagated the falsehood that it has defeated Boko Haram, when statistics shows that in the first tenure of Buhari, 25,794 Nigerians were killed? In that number, Boko Haram alone was responsible for the killing of 5,598 people. Is that not falsehood? They wish to completely remove the freedom of Nigerians, but we must refuse. We must refuse to replace Abacha-style dictatorship, military dictatorship, with civilian autocracy. Let us go back to the beginning. The worst lies, propagation of falsehood and manipulation ever made against a people in the 21st century is the 2015 manifesto of the ruling party known as the All Progressive Congress, APC. I challenge all civil society organizations in Nigeria to come together and take legal action against the APC and their so-called change mantra embodied in that manipulative document which they referred to as an honest contract for Nigeria. They deceived us by their falsehood and manipulated us into voting for them in 2015. And that is the same document they are using till now, 2019. Till date, they did not keep one of their false promises. They lured us into their change agenda. Every manifesto is a social contract with the people. Now, let us see some of their falsehood and manipulation in their manifesto. They promised to initiate action to amend our constitution with a view to devolving powers, excuse me, duties and responsibilities to states and local government in order to entrench true federalism and the federal spirit. Have they kept that promise? No. Falsehood and manipulation. They promised to begin widespread consultation to amend the constitution to enable states and local government to employ state and community police to address the peculiar needs of each community. Have they kept that promise? No. Falsehood and manipulation. They promised to amend the constitution to remove immunity from prosecution for elected officers in criminal cases. Have they kept that promise? No. Falsehood and manipulation. Instead, they promote people who have corruption cases to be ministers. They promised to strengthen INEC to reduce and eliminate electoral malpractices. Have they kept that promise? No. falsehood and manipulation. Today, INEC is a tool of government to fight. They promised to reform and strengthen the justice system for efficient administration and dispensation. Did they keep the promise? No. Falsehood and manipulation. Today, the laws of Nigeria are no longer respected. Court orders are no more obeyed. They promised that they will make our economy one of the fastest emerging economies in the world with a real GDP growth average 10% annually. Did they do that? No. Falsehood and manipulation. They promised to formulate a robust industrialization policy and provide a conducive environment. Today, we are so insecure that we cannot even be talking about industrialization. This government, they promised to generate, transmit, and distribute from the current 5,000 to 6,000 megawatts to at least 20,000 megawatts of electricity within 4 years. It's now more than 4 years. Did they do that? No. Falsehood and manipulation. All of this falsehood and manipulations of this government is enough to impeach a president. It's enough. Have they lied to us? They also lied that they will modernize NNPC and make it the national energy champion. Is it happening? No. Falsehood and manipulation. They said that they are targeting up to 15% of our annual budget for education. Have they done that after 4 years? No. Falsehood and manipulation. They promised to establish at least 6 universities of science and technology with satellite campuses in various states. Did they do that? No. Falsehood and manipulation. The only thing we are hearing is that Aisha Buhari would like to build a university in honor with the name of her husband. They promised to increase the quality of federal government-owned hospitals to world-class standards within 5 years. These people are joking with us. Do we have that? No! Falsehood and manipulation. Even the president is running away to the UK to enjoy world-standard hospitals built by the policies of wise politicians. They promised to guarantee that women are adequately represented in government. Did they do that? In government appointments. Did they do that? No. Today we have 42 ministers and just 7 are women. Nigerian federal legislators should sit up and come up with concrete laws that will bring about visible developments. Stop talking about talking. Some legislators have been there for like 16 years with nothing to show for it. They are the embodiment of everything that's wrong with Nigeria. If you have been in the legislature for more than 8 years and Nigeria is getting worse under your watch, then you are the cause of our problems as a people. The ones that have been there for a long time are the ones that teach new legislators how to pad our budget. The 2020 budget already, they have padded about 3 billion naira in the budget. Something that they will not spend later, they will take the money and put in their pocket. Later, you will find out that amount will even increase more than that, about 3 billion that has been discovered. Can you imagine that? And this is a country that is borrowing to finance a budget. And a government that is purportedly fighting corruption. In the year 2016, the court ordered through the application of SERAP that President Buhari should prosecute some senators that padded our budget with 481 billion naira. 481 billion naira is enough to provide steady electricity to FCT, Abuja, and environs. Buhari refused to prosecute them. And we are borrowing. And we are borrowing. And if you look at some of the longest serving legislators, many of them have been there receiving salaries with nothing to show for what they have been paid for. Let's look at the list of some of the senators there. One, we have Senator Philip Tanimu Adoda, 2003 till date. He's called the landlord of the Senate as if it is his personal property. We have Senator Ike Ekweremadu, 2003 till date. He has been deputy Senate president for 12 years. And the Niger Bridge is still there. So when we talk about marginalization by the federal government, we must also talk about our governors, legislators, local government chairpersons, and others. We must ask them what they are doing, and the ministers too. Senator John Owan Eno has been there from 2003 to date. Senator Ahmed Ibrahim Lawan, 1999 to date. Senators John David Mack and Senator Nicholas Mutu, they were there for 20 years. When Senator Mark left, he sponsored his daughter, who is now a member of the House of Reps. That is how they represent themselves. And before you know it, Nigeria will be fighting new pharaohs. Yes. We have Kabiru Marafa Achida, House of Reps, 2003 till date. Yakubu Bade, House of Reps, 2003 till date. Representative Leo Ogo, House of Representatives, 2003 till date. Senator James Manager has been there, 2003 till date. Senator Ali Ndume, 2003 till date. In November 2011, Senator Ndume was alleged to be linked with Boko Haram. Femi Gbajabiamila, House of Reps, 2003 till date, now current speaker. So these are people that have been there for many years. What have they done? What have they done? They are distracting us from seeing their ineptitude. That is why they want us to discuss, to just talk. I said that is our problem. The laws that we need to move, that we need to move Nigeria forward, include the following one: an urgent review of the total overhaul of the Constitution of the Federal Republic of Nigeria. Two, consideration and adoption of parts of the 2014 Confab report. Nigerians from all parts of the country came up with a report. Billions of naira was spent for that Confab. Till date, nothing has been done about it. And that report can solve most of our problems that we have today as a people. Three, we need a law that will restructure the country into 6 geopolitical zones. Four, a law that will guarantee 100% electronic voting. Once you miss an election, you miss good governance for 4 years. Apart from electronic voting, we want an election. We want a voting system that Nigerians should be able to vote with your mobile phone at home. You don't need to go to police stations where helicopters will be spraying tear gas with police people, police officers in the air, spraying tear gas to scatter elections. Or ballot bus thieves. Or people being shot today. You can vote from the convenience of your home. It's an easy system to do. These are the type of laws we should be talking about in Nigeria to solve our problems. Five, we need a law that will guarantee Nigerian diaspora to vote as from 2023. We are waiting for the intelligent senator that will present such bills. Six, we need a law that will make it compulsory that all the 774 local government areas in Nigeria, they must have a farm, state of the art, plant according to your highest comparative advantage or least comparative disadvantage. That is, if your area is good for cassava, plant. If it is good for piggery, fishing, perform, plant, invest. By the time you suffocate Nigeria with enough food, you will stimulate the economy, crime will stop, employment will increase, and many of these problems we have today will not be there. These are laws that we should be talking about. Not the Minister of Agriculture telling us that there's no hunger in Nigeria simply because it's not in touch with the people. A country that has 94 million people living in extreme poverty, which is more than about 20 countries in Europe, you are saying that that is not hunger. Seven, we need a law that will declare that a governor or president must pay back every money that he borrows within his 4 years in office. You cannot borrow, steal, and leave debt behind for future generations to pay. If you cannot pay back within your 4 years, don't borrow. If you cannot pay back, when you leave office, you pay from your private pocket. Those are the type of laws we need in Nigeria. Eight, we need a law that prescribes death sentence or minimum life imprisonment for corrupt officials. Death sentence is what tribes in the China that we borrow money from. That was how they became rich too. What sense does it make when you prescribe death sentence by hanging, death by hanging for hate speech, and you apply plea bargain for high-level thieves in office and reintegrated the so-called Boko Haram, repentant Boko Haram people into the same society? No death sentence for them, no hanging for them. But when you talk, how you will close our mouth, we will know. How you will do that, we will know. We will know. Trillions of naira has been spent on the legislator, since 1999, with nothing to show for it. All we have to show for what we have spent on the legislature is poverty capital of the world. I am saying that Nigerian senators allocate 3 billion naira individually to themselves every year. Multiply that by 108 senators. How much will you get? 327 billion. Multiply that by the 4 years they spend in office, you will have 1,308,000,000,000 naira. Now, we have 36 states in Nigeria plus FCT, let's say 37 states. Divide 1,308,000,000,000 naira by those 37 states. One state will receive 35.3 billion. That amount is enough to build 18 standard hospitals. That is, if one hospital is costing about conservatively 2 billion naira, it means that we can build standard 18 hospitals in each of the states in Nigeria. And Buhari will not be traveling abroad. Within 4 years, 18 in every state of the country. Those are the issues we should be discussing about. They are distracting us. That's why they are talking nonsense about hate speech and a plagiarized bill of falsehood and manipulation. Nigeria needs civil disobedience. Nigerian workers, you must stop being the monkey that walks for bamboo to chop. If we must be free as a people, the Nigerian Association of Nigeria, National Association of Nigerian Students, NANS, National Judicial Council, Nigerian Bar Association, Nigerian Union of Journalists, Nigerian Labour Congress, they must come together, set an agenda where we the people go on civil disobedience. Not going to the street to protest so that they don't shoot you. We stay at home, close the banks, close the school, close the markets, close everywhere, no transportation, no fuel supply, until the government respects the rule of law, they take action, until they reduce the salaries of these legislators. If not, they will not have time to be bringing this kind of nonsense laws. Until they reduce their salaries, until things are done properly in Nigeria, until the laws of the law of the land are respected. How can the Nigerian Judicial Council and NBA be silent when the president is defecating on our constitution, the same constitution that he swore on oath to protect and to preserve? A court gives order, you blatantly refuse, and the people are keeping silent. We breed dictatorship with our silence. Nigerians, arise. God bless the Federal Republic of Nigeria.